Please stand and remove all hats for the singing of our national anthem. Thank you. Please be seated. Good morning and welcome, families, friends, faculty, and most importantly, the Interboro class of 2023. First, I'd like to begin by saying thank you. Thank you to the parents, faculty, and staff. Thank you for your hard work, your dedication, and the effort you put into making this school a community for students to grow. Thank you to my own family for always supporting me through everything. I would like to dedicate this beautiful moment to my best friend and the dazzling woman who I get to call my mother, Freshia Scarrier. My mother never gave me any idea that I couldn't do whatever I wanted to do or be whomever I wanted to be. Thank you, Mom. Everything I've done is for you. All we've ever wanted to do was grow up. We grew up anxiously staring at the clock until the bell would ring at the end of the day. We grew up creating short stories. Which eventually evolved into writing research papers. We grew up reading picture books and soon moved on to chapter books. Here we are today, closing this chapter of our lives and turning the page to a new one. We never stopped to realize how fast we were growing up. We grew up dreaming about the day we could get our licenses, joking about how we couldn't wait to leave this place, and how we wished we could finally be on our own. Our journeys never slowed down, and honestly, it seems like our lives are speeding up. We grew up making memories that will last a lifetime, from going to Bucs football games every Friday night while cheering on our team for the district championship, to getting ready for our final homecoming weekend, to attending senior prom, to presenting our final project, and realizing this is really it. Our story at Interboro is almost over, and it's now our time to make the colleges, work fields, or people around us realize what a Buccaneer is truly capable of. As juniors, we said 1 year left until that year became a few months, and eventually 5 days were remaining as we until we shared our final moments as Interboro seniors. We never realized how much we would want another minute. One more minute to listen to Soroka discuss the basics of government. One more minute to sit in Acklands as she goes over a poem. One more minute to laugh with friends at lunch. One more minute to enjoy being in high school. We were all caught up in the chaos around us, and some of us may have never got to stop and truly appreciate these final moments. If I can teach any of you anything from this, it would be that we spend too much time wanting something to end that we never truly appreciate it. So please take a moment to stop and enjoy what is happening now and continue to do this as you go on your separate paths. Once you walk across the stage, take a moment to look around and appreciate the journey that has led you to this day. Take one moment to see everyone before rushing out of this hot field. That 1 minute will make a difference. Lastly, I would like to leave you all with a quote by Dr. Seuss. You have brains in your head, you have feet in your shoes, you can steer yourself in any direction you choose. The power lies within your hands to make your future. Do not let your circumstances hold you back, and never let someone else define the characteristics of an Interboro Buccaneer. Because as I know you all here today, I can proudly say that each and every one of you is capable of whatever your dreams may hold. Congratulations again to the Interboro class of 2023. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. William Phelps, board president. I'd like to welcome our fellow board members, administrators, staff, parents, and of course the students. Class of 2023, you stepped into Interboro High School 4 years ago and probably thought graduation was an eternity away. Since that first day of high school, every move that you've made, every risk that you've taken, whether big or small, took you towards your future that was completely yours to write. Your dreams and achievements have brought you all to this moment, and hope that you are looking ahead with excitement. Your biggest fans are here today, and they are excited to see what you will accomplish with all that you have learned here at Interboro. Make the most of your strength and determination to overcome obstacles that you have shown here the last 4 years, and the achievement and success that you were designated for. Buck pride and excellence are not just words. They represent this portion of your life. It is part of you and will remain with you and be a beacon of light that shines away to help you achieve your dreams. Continue to make Buck pride and excellence part of your journey. Congratulations, class of 2023. Thank you, train. And God bless you in your endeavors and for all your dreams. I hope they all come true. I can't tell you how proud we are of each and every one of you and how much love that the district puts out for you. God bless you.
Good morning, Interboro class of 2023. As the superintendent of schools, it is my honor to speak to you today. First and foremost, I want to congratulate each and every one of you on your achievements. Graduating from high school is no small feat, and you should all be incredibly proud of yourselves. Today is not just about celebrating your accomplishments. It is also about looking ahead to the future. As you move on to the next phase of your lives, I encourage you to continue to strive for greatness. Whether you are headed to college, joining the workforce, the military, or pursuing other interests, remember that you have the power to shape your own destiny. I also want to remind you that your education does not end with your high school diploma. Learning is a lifelong process, and I urge you to continue to seek out new knowledge and opportunities for growth. Whether it is through formal education or through experiences in the world around you, never stop learning. Finally, I want to encourage you to use your talents and abilities to make a positive impact on the world. You are the future leaders and change makers, and I have no doubt that you will rise to the occasion. Be kind, be compassionate, and be bold in your pursuits. Once again, congratulations to you, congratulations to all your families, and best of luck in all your future endeavors. And remember, once a buck, always a buck. Thank you.
Greetings to fellow students, faculty, family, and friends. I'd like to dedicate the speech to my wonderful parents. Life for you has been hard, starting anew in a foreign country with only an itinerary and a dream. Was the abruptness of it all enough for you to prepare for me? You didn't begin at the same starting line as everyone else here, but your immigrant status didn't limit how far either of you could reach. If it hadn't been for me, you could have reached the stars. Day by day, I am motivated by the chapped hands of my father who has worked tirelessly in a factory. I am driven by the sore back and feet soles of my tenacious mother who has bent down for hours, working at a nail salon and in college when I was a child, and who has pushed her way through to work at a medical lab. No amount of I love yous or thank yous can ever express how grateful I am to your dedication to raising me. I'll always remember that it's your shoulders I stand on. Your support has gotten me this far, and I am proud to announce that I will be attending Yale University this fall and be the first in my family to attend an Ivy League. I'd also like to give a short thank you to my family and my parents' villages currently watching in Vietnam. Gan mong, gan nha, thương con và ủng hộ con. Thank you for loving and supporting me. On that note, here is my message to express your appreciation. It has been a long 4 years, but here we are, ready to graduate. We worked hard to get to this point, but we didn't do it by ourselves. We owe huge debt of gratitude to the following people. To our teachers, thank you for so unselfishly sharing your time, talent, and knowledge with us. Yes, we know it was your job to do it, but what you did for us went beyond the call of duty. You took the time to explain assignments, sometimes repeatedly because we weren't paying attention. You allowed us to come to your classroom after school for extra help when you could have gone home to spend time with your family. You demanded excellence from us whether or not we wanted to give it. You set the bar high and challenged us to live up to it. To our parents, thank you for supporting us in more ways than is possible to count. You dragged us out of bed each morning and made sure we were fed and clothed for school. You herded us out the door or drove us to school yourselves. You helped us with homework, paid our class fees, and listened to our complaints. You came to our plays and attended our sporting events and ceremonies. You commiserate over our daily dramas, but you try to give us enough space to learn how to work things out for ourselves. These are just a few of the thousands of ways you've supported us on our journey. To our coaches and advisors, thank you for making school about more than just classwork. Through sports, we learn how to power on through adversity and give it our best effort, win or lose. We learn the importance of discipline and good sportsmanship. To our custodial staff, bathroom monitors, and lunchroom attendants, thank you for keeping our school clean and safe. You know better than anyone else what slobs we've been, especially in those bathrooms. You really deserve some kind of medal. To our principal, assistant principals, and all the office staff, thank you for keeping things running smoothly so our teachers can concentrate on us. To our guidance counselors, thank you for listening and trying to keep us on the right track for graduation. Without your help, some of us might not be graduating today. As you can see, behind each graduate, there must have been at least a dozen people providing support in at least a dozen ways. The best way we graduates can show our gratitude is to make the most of the opportunity we've been given and show our gratitude and go forward into the world with the intention of making it a better place for the generations that follow us. We'll pay that gratitude forward. Whether you highly anticipate or fear what comes next, or perhaps feel a mixture of both, we will all be entering what is known as the real world soon. As someone who has already spent time exploring the school's four walls, beyond the school's four walls, I can confidently say that the world has a lot to offer, and I implore you all to dream big. The scary part is that we're on our own now, but the nice part is that we're on our own now. And to that, let's celebrate new beginnings and a step into the next chapter. Thank you.
Good morning. Honorable administrators, esteemed faculty, distinguished guests, relieved parents, ward siblings, and of course, the 2023 graduating class of Interboro High School. Throughout these last 4 years, we have had experiences that we will continue to carry for years to come. Together, we have conquered countless challenges, triumphed over adversity, and have grown into the remarkable individuals that we are today. Whether we realize it or not, our time at Interboro High School has molded us and prepared us for the road ahead. As we leave this high school physically, let us reflect on all of the valuable lessons that our time here has taught us. Throughout our high school years, we have witnessed the transformative powers of hard work and dedication. We have spent countless hours in classrooms pushing ourselves to excel academically. We have immersed ourselves in extracurricular activities, whether on the sports field, in the arts, or in service to the community. We have strived to leave a mark, to make a difference, and to realize our fullest potential. We have deepened our understanding of who we are and who we wish to become. While I am in no means an accurate source of timeless wisdom, I would like to share a quote with you today, which has helped me along the way. Elevate yourself through the power of your mind, and do not degrade yourself, for the mind can be the friend and also enemy of the self. Bhagavad Gita, chapter 6, verse 5. These profound words remind us of the importance of hard work and dedication. In any field which we may wish to pursue in the future, the path of diligent work will always nearly guarantee arrival to the end goal. While we may not be in direct control of the outcomes, we do have the power to decide the steps we take to getting closer to the goal. All of these steps originate from the mind. With unwavering determination, it is possible to work towards any personal goals that you may have. On the other hand, a lack of determination delays progress. So no matter what endeavors you are about to embark upon, be sure to give them your very best effort. The bright futures that lie ahead of us are filled with countless aspirations. In the pursuit of these dreams, however, let us never forget the power of hard work, the significance of dedication, and the resilience that lies within each and every one of us. Remember, dream is not the thing which you see in sleep, but is the thing that doesn't let you sleep. Firm commitment to our goals allow us to realize our fullest potential and overcome any setbacks that may arrive. On this joyous occasion, I would like to express my heartfelt gratitude to all those who have supported me on this incredible journey. First and foremost, I would like to give a special thanks to my religious leaders, Pramukh Swami Maharaj and Mahant Swami Maharaj, for giving me guidance whenever I needed it. It is through their leadership and teachings that I'm able to find motivation and purpose in the things that I do. I personally want to thank my parents who have devoted everything for me. Both of my parents work tirelessly to assure that I don't face any discomfort, even if my comfort comes at the expense of theirs. I'm grateful for my brother who has always helped me through every little thing that I needed. Despite our never-ending arguments, it is he who I can always count on when I need help for something. And a special thanks to the rest of my family, my grandparents, and my cousins, and all others whose encouragement is endless. Enough thanks could not be given to the teachers and other faculty that have helped me along the way. Starting at Tinicum School, all the way to the end of high school, it is the teachers that have confidently given me all that I need to start my next chapter in life. The knowledge, wisdom, and guidance provided by all of my teachers is something which I will never be able to repay. Finally, to all of my friends, both in and out of school, a huge thank you. The memories that I have shared with you will remain with me forever. Through association with all of you, I have gained qualities that I hope to imbibe myself. Each and every one of us here has someone to thank for where we are today, so make sure you take the time to express that appreciation to them. So, with all that being said, congratulations to the Interboro High School class of 2023. May our futures be filled with endless possibilities, extraordinary accomplishments, and a profound impact on the world around us. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Gabrielle Capuano. And I'm a co-advisor for the Interboro High School class of 2023. First, I want to express my gratitude to all those who made this year so special. Thank you to the school board and central administration for all your hard work. Thank you to our high school administration team for your relentless dedication to our staff and students. Thank you to my colleagues for their unwavering support. The time and effort you consistently give to our students and to each other is truly special. Our students recognize and appreciate it more than you know. Lastly, I would like to recognize Mr. Jim Ryan, with whom I co-advised the class of 2023. You made this past year an exceptional one for this remarkable class, and I'm grateful to work alongside you. Now, to the class of 2023. Thank you all for this honor. It's a privilege to be chosen to give the charge for the class. Each one of you has brought something unique to this class throughout the years. Whether it be your academic achievements, athleticism, musical talent, humor, or kindness, you all have shared parts of the world with your classmates and teachers and allowed our community to see the pride you have in being yourselves. So when people asked me what I was going to say today and suggested I make a few jokes to get people to laugh, I thought to myself, well, that isn't me, especially because I'm not funny. I'm really not. Instead, I want to thank all of you sitting right in front of me for allowing me to be myself. From your first day of school, you all accepted me for being who I am, with my loud voice projecting up and down the hallways. You never made me feel like I had to be someone else. So my hope for you, as you embark on this new chapter of your life, is that you continue to be yourselves. In a world where it's easy to fall into the trap of comparing yourself to others, the idea of just be yourself is easier said than done. As you walk across the stage today, you might have plans and goals for your future, but don't be afraid if those goals and plans change. Your idea of happiness may continuously evolve, and it may look different than what you're envisioning right now. You may change career paths, live someone unexpected, or have certain experiences that change your outlook on what matters most. Maybe what your life turns out to be in the next 10 years is not what you had at all planned. And I want to tell you that it's okay. You don't have to have your whole life figured out today, tomorrow, or in the next 10 years. When it comes to being yourself, give yourself grace. Change is healthy. Trust yourself as you make decisions. The world will likely judge you no matter who you are or what you do. You can't make everyone happy, and you shouldn't sacrifice your own happiness to try to please others. The world deserves to see you, and you deserve to live in a way that is true to yourself. You have the power to make your life whatever you want it to be, and it is never too late to pursue your dreams. Be confident in what you do and have fun. Everyone wants to have a successful life, but success means different things for different people. Measure success by your own values. So whatever success looks like for you, remember to share it with the people who mean the most. The people who show you unconditional love, who support your dreams, and who make you feel that you can do anything you want in this world. As you go through this new chapter of your life, remember that those are the people who make all the successes worthwhile and keep us going when times get tough. I've often heard many students say, "Miss Cap, you're always in a good mood and you're still so loud, I just don't get it." This Interboro community plays a huge part in that. It comes together when someone needs help, and that is something you do not find very often. It is supportive and makes you want to be a better person because of the consistent kindness everyone shows one another. On a personal note, it comes from my friends and family, especially my mom and dad, who have played another huge part in shaping my outlook and attitude. They have supported me and motivated me to work harder. They want to see me be the best possible version of myself, and they push me until I can see that for myself. Whoever does this for you in your life, hold them close. They will stand by you through the good and bad times and will help you find the success you set out to achieve. So on that note, I want to say congratulations to the family and friends of this year's graduating class. You too share in this significant achievement. And most importantly, congratulations to the class of 2023. You did it. This is a huge accomplishment, and I hope you are as proud of yourself as I am. The train cannot be louder than me, don't worry. I wish you all the best of luck in this new adventure. I will miss you all and think about your senior year with fond memories. Remember to be yourself, surround yourself with the best support team, and have fun. Life is way too short not to enjoy the ride. Thank you.
Good morning, Board of Directors, Superintendent Riley, administrators, staff, parents and guardians, and the class of 2023. We're finally here. Welcome to this special day. My name is Brian Litz, and I've had the privilege of being your high school principal this year. The theme for this year's amazing yearbook couldn't be more perfect as we rewind, replay, and relive the pictures, happenings, and memories of the 2022-2023 school year. But what strikes me as I reflect is the rewind theme. Rewinding to a time for all of us that feels a bit more normal, a bit more routine, a bit more like that we used to know. It's this class, the class of 2023, that has made me feel that sense of rewind. And that's a testament to who this class is and their focus on moving forward, taking advantage of the opportunities before them. Speaking of rewind, I, along with many of you, reflect on what has been some difficult times for our Buck family. Many of us have dealt with loss, anxiety, illness, and other challenges, all while attempting to learn the skills and tools needed to succeed in a different world. Your ninth grade year was not what any of us envisioned for the start of your high school experience, but it's obvious now more than ever that it's how you respond to such adversity. Besides a difficult start, you've also had to deal with the heartache that comes with losing your own. The best way to respect those we've lost is to take advantage of the opportunities you do have, as unfortunately those we've lost will never get that chance. So as I rewind to relive the way by which we pulled together through the pandemic, I am still in awe of the work performed by our health and nurse office under the leadership of Ms. Karen Gardner. In the office by her side throughout was Ms. Terry Stewart. This year, Terry is retiring after 20 years of service, and we thank her for all she has given of herself, the Interboro School District, and especially her tireless efforts these last few years in helping us through these challenging times. Thank you, Ms. Stewart. You've certainly been a key piece in supporting all of us. So lately, I've rewound a bit in search of that one time, that one moment, when I knew we had something special going on this school year. And I absolutely remember it vividly. It was Friday, September 30th at our home football game versus Kenny. It was that night, right there, that I saw the leadership and respect by this class towards each other, their school, and community. I remember being completely in awe of what I was witnessing. These students made a clear choice to band together to show, as a group, what it means to exhibit Buck pride. And all I could think to myself was, as I watched it unfold, was we're back. Class of 2023, you've absolutely showed up and stepped up to give us all the school and community pride to count on, be it at the football games, in the school building, or out in the community. For this, a heartfelt thank you for modeling for the rest of the school and showing how it's done at Interboro High School and how it's done in this community. Class of 2023, take a look at your teachers seated around you. They have the hardest and what cannot some days feel like the most rewarding job in the world. The passion and resiliency they have shown throughout your high school career is nothing short of amazing. You may not realize it, but these teachers work as hard for you as if you were their own, and it shows. Thank you, teachers, for being the mentors our students deserve and for molding this amazing class. And this brings me to my advice to the class of 2023. I'm going to share a few things for you to keep in mind as you move forward, and I feel I'm qualified to do so, because just as you are venturing into uncharted territory, I was too at this time last year as I headed into my first full year as your principal. So I'm going to help you out with a few things that I found out along the way. One, surround yourself with good people who can help you and utilize them to help get you where you need to be. I happen to have 92 teachers and counselors, 12 instructional support staff members, 8 maintenance department workers, 13 cafeteria personnel, 3 in the health office, 78 transportation department members, a school resource officer, and a legend running our student council. By the way, no one puts Andy in the corner. You're probably not going to have all these people right now, but in the meantime, keep those people who have a voice of reason and a sense of self around you. These people have nothing to gain by steering you wrong, so they won't. Ask for help from these people when you need it. If they didn't want to help, they wouldn't be here. Last week, I was reminded by one of you seated here that you need a few go-to people that are able to support you when you need it. They may not have all the answers, but they probably have a couple. Because you're not going to have all the answers, not even close, so don't pretend that you do. People will respect your humility and willingness to learn. Be thankful that you have these people around, and absolutely do not take them for granted. Thank you, teachers and staff, for guiding our students and for guiding me as we navigate this calling that we share together. My second piece of advice is the realization that you have to start somewhere. You'll be overwhelmed by the amount of work it takes to achieve success, but tackle something, anything, to get started. Often it can start with a deep breath and a shift in your mindset. Putting just that one foot forward is the best way to get to where you need to be. You may not be quite sure of where you want to be or what that looks like, but you've got to move ahead somewhere, somehow. Take some risks and you'd be surprised where you might go. Not everything, no matter how hard you try, will go according to plan, and that's okay. Nobody has all the pieces fall perfectly in place, but you've got to be working with some pieces. Don't walk around empty-handed. Make a plan the best you can, even if you don't know exactly how it's going to all fit together. It will give you direction. So don't put so much pressure on yourself that you do not have fun on the journey. Expect the unexpected and embrace whatever may come your way. Next, be engaged. It is way too easy nowadays to sidestep what might take effort, but if you take the path of least resilience, you will not be the best you can be, not even close. Good things take focus and effort, and you have to be right in the middle of it all in order to achieve success. Roll up the sleeves and get in the game and be mentally and emotionally invested to get out of your comfort zone. It is way too easy to knock out the easy tasks, so be sure to make that conscious effort to get engaged with the hard stuff, which again, start with a small step. Engage with the outside world, and guess what? Liking a post on social media does not count. Be an original. It's enough to just be you and make your mark on the world. Now more than ever, there are tools you can use to invent a career path or create something new so you can literally make your passion your job. It's this passion that fuels the engagement. As your class co-advisor, Mr. Ryan, told you last week, find your passion, any passion, funnel it and let it snowball. The beauty of it is that no one can tell you that your passion isn't worth it. Your passion will get you engaged, and it's yours alone. As Nelson Mandela once said, there is no passion to be found playing small and settling for a life that is less than the one you are capable of living. I respectfully translate that to you as, always be bigger than the room you're playing. Thinking back to that one football game and the tone it set for the rest of the school year, and I can't help but come back to the respect that this class shows our community, to staff, and to each other. And that's the final piece to keep in mind as you take on the world. Continue to be respectful of others, and especially yourselves as well. It's the right thing to do, but also because you never know where that respect can lead you. It could be that first impression that can open a door. It could be that act of kindness that inspires another. And also, again, it's just the way you need to act in order to give yourself the respect that you deserve. As novelist Lawrence Stern once said, respect for ourselves guides our morals, respect for others guides our manners. You've got a lot coming at you with social media and instantaneous communication. A lot of people have access to you, and many of them will not show the respect that you know you need to have for yourself and for others. Stay the course, do the right thing that's been taught to you by your families and teachers, and, you know, maybe get off your phone once in a while you're at it. Overall, I'll leave you with a final thought. You can have all the intellect and drive, but if you can't listen, not just hear, but really listen to others, then it's not going to matter. I can't give you the advice needed to succeed in your life's work, because as I mentioned earlier, chances are you're pursuing a goal that may not have ever been seen before. But besides listening, the common denominator is collaboration. You have to be willing to collaborate and empathize with others. Without it, you'll never be the leader you need to be in order to be the creative original that makes its mark on what's out there. Move forward with respect and pride. The pride you have in yourself, the pride you gave us on that Friday night back in September, and the pride, the Buck pride, this community has for you. Thank you, and good luck to the class of 2023. On behalf of the faculty and staff of Interboro High School, I present for your review, Mrs. Riley, and for the review of the Board of Directors of the Interboro School District, the class of 2023. As principal of the high school, I verify that these young men and women assembled before you have met all the graduation requirements established by the Interboro School District and the Department of Education of the state of Pennsylvania. At this time, I formally request that you accept as graduates the Interboro High School Class of 2023. To begin and assist in the awarding of the diplomas, I proudly present the President of the Class of 2023, Kim Nguyen, and the Vice President, Joyce Dunn.
Isaiah Supley. Nicholas Stewart. Riley Tarpey. Victoria Smith. Allison Perillo. Morgan May. Felicia Pescator. Isabella Tanzi. Yassine Majane. Karan Patel. Juliana Wisely. Verhanas Askerier. Gabrielle Haney. Grace Finley. Alexa McDevin. Sarah Schreiber. Riley Berkheimer. Connor Robovitsky. Georgia Curtin. Akaya Stevenson. Quentin Seifer. Maya Hitchner.
Evan Wright. Sarah Ewing. Brian Stockett. Colin Sears. Dylan Smith. Gabriel Reefer. Michael Northrop. Ibrahim Sulahi. Shania Woods. Layla McDuffie. Freddie Toapanta. Jason Yag. Colin McGovern. Abigail Dougherty. Aiden Dougherty. Gianna Amalfitano. Quentin Barker. Sabhan Ahmad. Caitlin Betson. Olivia DeFrancisco. Rocco Barone. Nicole Franz. Haley Baroni. Natalie Hansen. Vincent Lilly.
Edwin Torres. Tiffany Topper. Abubakar Kamara. Mason McCoy. Finnegan Lehman. Evan Mullen. Abigail Palmer. Kaylee Wagner. Olivia Lee. Mona Lehan. Rebecca Roberts. Alexis Chow. Joshua Borkowski. Imani Harris. Kennedy Balak. Kaylin Deal. Amaya Cokes. Danielle Halloran. Jada Gibson. Julian Olivas. Matthew Galanoff. Imani Daniel. Asani Carmona.
Ryan Russell. Olivia Orlandini. Anthony Packwood. Valerie Vincolati. Shaylee Porter. Jamie Delaney. Vincent Schaffer. Bridget Torrance. Madison Wagon. Brenna Taylor. Ava Kennedy. Tanaya Cooper. Daniel Medina. Sophia Quaid. Jamie Alvarez Brown. Kayla Andrews. Christopher Costa. Liam Dooney.
Samuel Brooks. walls. William N. Momenti. Sanaya Wright. Luke Motley. Taxier Kabir. Robert Tone. Robert Lombardo. Gabriel Mangano. Nancy Rogers. Abdul Kamara. Jada Tabron Butler. Thomas McCanns. Alexander Bobby. Maximilian Hershey. Cody Bachman. Monier Alikasim. Ebenezer Afeni. Fiona Hennings. Amir Holloway Brown. Luke Dunleavy. Christopher Capriccio. Dominic Gunter. Michael Jones. Tolu Awoyemi.
David Ziegler. Jacob Douglas. Kira White. Rania Mehta. Shannon Rooney. Devin Yoakum. Charlie McCoy. Jose Mendez. Aaliyah Valentine. Veda Myers. Richard Newcomb. Daryl Thomas. Jaden McLeod. Uthman Ghaznavi. Kevin Bellilli. Isaiah Bungie. Musa Donzo. Francis Hofner. Bryce Butler. Kaylin Bauer-Smith. Theodore Diamopoulos. Damian Davis. Victoria Farrell. Jessica Everett. Patrick Awu.
Devin Stowe. Brian Ledger. Andrew Simmons. Isabella Luby. Miley Schaefer. Liam Schaefer. Brady Newell. Thomas Pace. John Phillips. Kylie May. Aiden Van Dries. Amari Parker. Robert Strange. Haley Gaynor. Chloe Alkins. Travis Chamberlain. Patrick Brennan. Emily Dazikas. Lisa Marie Kolika. Elena Delacat. Emily Gillespie. Casey Yitao. Gaddy Abu. Noah Doran. Jacob DeHart.
Johnny Nguyen. Diana Cherubin. Taylor Russetto. Carmela Rosa. Shannon Lewis. Ryder Sakers. Logan Roberts. Kyle Manasian. Gavin Oliva. Hayden Mowbray. John Newsham. Mason Nolan. Alfred Thomas. John DiMaggio. Nicholas Izzy. Robert Cresswell. Madison Brown. Joseph Bremen. James Bergeball Foster. Drew Hale. Scott Ingram. Alex Hum. Nathan Eisenfelder. Jared Denman. Timothy Farah.
Corey Lipcha. Kevin Waters. Salvatore Sabatina. Francis Suga. Dominic Velarde. Aiden McLaren. Annie Torrey. Riley Stefano. Ethan Lawrence. Joshua Burnside. Michael Gonzalez. Lucas DeVirgilius.
Including the class of 2023, please stand and join in singing our school alma mater. Following the alma mater, we also graduates will please remain in your seats until escorted out by the marshals. Once again, if we could have everybody please stand for the singing of our school alma mater. Thank you.